What is going on, guys? It is Taylor Roberts, and welcome to another reaction video. I am excited because I'm about to do this channel's first deep dive. Basically, I'm going to pick an artist that I'm unfamiliar with his or her work, and I'm gonna go back to their very first album, and I'm gonna react and listen and review each one of their albums until we reach the current album. And it's gonna be awesome because I'm gonna be able to see where an artist started and watch how they develop into the artist that they are now, Lana Del Rey. Now, I'm familiar with some of her work because she works with The Weeknd every once in a while, so I've heard her on some Weeknd tracks. But as far as her own solo projects, I really have no idea. One album reaction each week coming out on Monday. So guys, make sure you subscribe, hit that little bell button so you get notifications of when these new videos drop. Shout out to all my new subscribers. What's up, guys? Thank you for subscribing. I appreciate it. Last but not least, hop on over to Instagram, give me a follow. I'm gonna follow you back. And let's not waste any more time. I'm anxious to get into the music. Let's get right into it. Ooh. Hold up, I just want to say I felt like that little string intro at the very beginning of this song, it felt like I was watching, I was at a theater, you know, and the curtains just opened up and the show was about to start. Very classic Hollywood. Feet don't fail me now. Take me to the finish line. All my heart, it breaks every step that I take. Like I told you, honey, don't make me sad, don't make me cry. Sometimes life is not enough and the road gets tough. I don't know why. Keep making me laugh. Let's go get high.
Those harmonies. Harmonies, man, they're like goosebumps. Great, great opening track. I mean, it opens you up to this world, this vibe and this sound. The vocals have a very classic feeling to them, and the music has a very classic feeling to it. But the difference is that they've added kind of hip-hop drums to it, which kind of takes that, it's weird. It's like a modern classic, I guess.
My old man is a bad man, but I can't deny the way he holds my hand and he grabs me. He has me by my heart. He doesn't mind. Oof. I have a Las Vegas past. He doesn't mind I have a LA crass way about me. He loves me with every beat of his cocaine heart.
Damn.
Swimming pool, glimmering darling. Watch me in the swimming pool, bright blue ripples. You sitting, sipping on your black crystal. Oh, yeah. Light of my life, fire in my loins. Be a good baby, do what I want. Light of my life, flat broke down life. In fact, he says he thinks it's why he might like about me. Admires me the way I roll like a rolling stone. Likes to watch me in the classroom, bathroom,
again. Very like term. A lot of turbulence.
Says it feels like heaven.
I love that, a little riffing in the background. I'm loving this old school vibe album has been giving off so far. I just want to get into her vocal performance here in this song. I mean, not only is the music cinematic in itself, but her visual descriptiveness and her lyrics helps also paint a picture of what's going on. But just the way she sings her lyrics, the verse is almost like she's recounting a story. But as she gets into the chorus, her vocal register goes up to a little bit, and at the very peak of the chorus, she almost sounds kind of like this little girl, and it kind of reminds me of those classic Hollywood sex symbols back in the day, like Marilyn Monroe, who would purposely sound like a little girl because it fits her image, and she seems like this shy little innocent girl. But with this, it seems like this character in this song, a portrayal or an image that she's putting off for him, but inside she's got some ulterior motives going on. Ooh. Ooh. Hold up.
Fresh to death and sick as cancer. You're a sort of punk rock.
Another great track so far. I mean, damn, she's just been killing it back to back so far. To back. Ugh. I apologize if I know I always, like, whenever I'm doing these reactions, I'm always, like, closing my eyes. It might seem like a little, but it's like, listening to this is like an experience, and with very cinematic music, which this is a very cinematic album, closing my eyes and I'm picturing this story going on in my head. So I apologize, you guys, if I'm closing my eyes too much, but I gotta take it all in, man. I gotta take it all in. Ooh, that harp is beautiful in the background.
Swinging in the backyard, pull up in your fast car, whistling my name. Open up a beer and you say get over here and play a video game. A man put his favorite perfume on, go play a video game. It's you, it's you, it's all for you. Everything I do, I tell you all the time. Heaven is a place on earth with you. Tell me all the things you wanna do. I heard that you like the bad girls, honey. Is that true? It's better than I ever even knew. They say that the world was built for two. Only worth living if somebody is loving you. It's you, it's you, it's all for you. Everything I do, I tell you all the time. Heaven is a place on earth with you. Tell me all the things you wanna do. I heard that you like the bad girls, honey. Is that true? It's better than I.
Again, another good track. I mean, it's a little slower than the others. Looks like we're slowing it down a little bit, but still a heavy, heavy song. Heavy, heavy song. I really love the harp that was kind of in the background a little bit, just kind of giving it this dream-like feeling to it, and the piano was very, like, this very soft piano playing just a couple chords to just, you know, help carry the music along. Felt a very dream-like song, and her vocals are they're so heavenly. They really are. Her vocals are in a league of their own. A little bit of a different vibe going on. I think this one has been my least favorite song on the album so far, but it doesn't take away from how great the song is at the same time. You know, I feel that this has been one of the weaker songs, but these drums, so hip-hop influenced, and they're meshing with this classical vibe, and like I say it again, it's weird, but it works, and it works amazingly.
This kind of sounds like Bittersweet Symphony. I don't know why I can't say that word at the moment. Again with the drums.
Money is the anthem of success. So before we go out, what's your address? I'm your national anthem. God, you're so handsome. Take me to the Hamptons, Bugatti Veyron. I said, can we party later on? He said, yes, yes, yes. And your party dress.
Getting a little bit of a different vibe with this song. In this one, we get a little more of her kind of lyrical, her lyricism. You know, she's kind of has this kind of hip-hop flow to her lyrics in this one, which with her voice sounds really nice. And again, you know, everything is just meshing this classic tone with this modern beat. Again, this is another one that hasn't been my favorite so far out of all of the songs that we listen to, but still, it mixes things up a little bit, especially now that we're almost in the middle of the album. It's a nice kind of change of pace. Ooh. It reminds me of like the opening titles of like playing Medal of Honor. If anybody's ever played Medal of Honor back when it was like World War II games, not Modern Warfare, but
all my friends tell me I should move on. I'm lying in the ocean singing your song.
Okay. Okay. I love that.
That's why I stay here, and there's no remedy for memory. Your face is like a melody. It won't leave my head. Your soul is haunting me and telling me that everything is fine. But I'm accepting my dreams tonight. Oh, 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 oh. Ah, ha, ha, ha.
Okay, this is my favorite song on the album so far now. That song was a roller coaster of feelings. Just the production level of the song is amazing. I wasn't expecting that beat switch up
in the middle of the song. But the way it happened is like I almost didn't even notice that it was a beat switch up, you know? It was just so smooth. Lyrically, I think this has been the best song. Vocal performance wise, I think it's been the best song. Sonically, this has been the best song. I think this song is the best song on the album so far for me. Whew. All right, that was an experience.
Not even they can stop me now. Will I be flying overhead? The heavy words can't bring me down. Boy, I've been raised from the dead. Don't even know how shit.
Another major track. I'm telling you, the production in these instrumentals is crazy. Crazy. I mean, you know, especially in this song, I'm sitting here just, you know, vibing out to a certain style, and all of a sudden that bridge kicks in and those drums pop in from nowhere and it just catches you off guard, just blows your fucking mind. It's always so unexpected. But when it does happen, it's like an eargasm. For real. Again.
Darling, ooh. Darling, doesn't have a problem lying to herself, cause her liquor's top shelf. It's alarming, honestly, how charming she can be, fooling everyone, telling them she's having fun. I'm lying. The boys, the girls, they all like Carmen. She gives them butterflies, but to cartoon eyes. She laughs like God, her mind's like a diamond. 40 or two nights, she's
that drop hit me in my gut. Who is Carmen? Does anybody know? I feel like this album so far has been somewhat autobiographical. It's like a autobiographical alternate reality type thing where she's, you know, the character is herself, but it's a characterized version of herself. And I feel like Carmen is possibly
you know, her alter ego, just like Lana Del Rey is essentially a character in the music industry. We all know her real name isn't Lana Del Rey, that it's a persona that she gives off for her music. It's the image. So in this world that we're in right now, when listening to this album, is Carmen the Lana Del Rey of this protagonist? Is Carmen now her alter ego that she's decided to take on now that she's a big singer? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments, what you guys think.
Said I was the most exotic flower. Holding me tight in our final hour. I don't know how you convince them and get them, babe. I don't know what you do. It's unbelievable. And I
Has Lana Del Rey ever done a James Bond theme? I don't think she has, right? And I don't know why, because she would be perfect. Perfect, perfect, perfect to do a James Bond theme. Come on, Hollywood, get with the program. If I ever direct the next James Bond film, I'll get Lana Del Rey.
Kiss me hard before you go. Summertime sadness. I just wanted you to know that baby, you're the best. I got my red dress on tonight. Dancing in the dark in the pale moonlight. Throw my hair up real big, beauty queen style. Heels off, I'm feeling alive. Oh my God.
Oof. Again with the drums.
Tonight.
This outro is nice. I have heard this song before. I think it was like a remix that I've heard though, so I haven't actually heard this original version before. And I seem to say it with every song, but the drums play such an integral part in these songs. I mean, almost all of these songs have a switch up to them that you don't expect. It's almost as if the drums are a character themselves. It's crazy, but it's awesome. And it's what keeps these songs, you know, fresh and different.
Remember how we used to party up all night, sneaking out looking for a taste of real life, drinking in the small town firelight, Pabst Blue Ribbon on ice, sweet 16 and we had a ride. Down the streets as they whistle high, high, stealing bullies' cars with the senior guys. Teacher said we'd never make it out alive. There she was, my little best friend, eyes in her hands, swaying in the wind. Oh, she starts to cry, mascara running down her little Bambi eyes. Wonder how I hate those guys. This is what makes us girls. We all look for heaven and we put love first. Table dancing at the local dive, cheering our names in the pink spotlight, drinking cherry schnapps in the velvet night. Yo, we used to go break in, build the hotel, glamour and we'd swim, running from the cops in our black bikini tops, screaming, get us while we're hot, get us while we're hot.
Come on, take a shot.
This is what makes us girls.
To be honest, I think the album closer was my least favorite song on this album. I just love the way, like I mentioned before, how the album opened with the big string overture. I just pictured curtains pulling away onto the stage, or from a theater in the 1940s of a film I was about to watch. It was a great opening, and this one, it just kind of seemed, it was very climactic toward the end and very chaotic and crazy, but I felt like I could feel the same way as maybe it's like the curtains were closing, or, you know, it closed off with a very like stringy overture type feel just to kind of even the album out a bit. Overall though, for her first, studio project, holy shit. It was, this way that she was able to take this kind of glamorous, classic Hollywood faded glory vibe and sound and just pour over, a glass of not only modern music, but modern hip hop music, and it being able to blend so well together. It baffles me sometimes because on paper, it doesn't seem like it would work, but here she manages to do it. Instrumental wise, again, I'm gonna say it, the production on this was fantastic. It was amazing. Each song had their own kind of characteristic feel, and the music kind of had its own storyline that was kind of playing along with the story that she was telling in her lyrics. And the drums, 100%, the drums, I feel, were like their own character in this story.
I feel like the drums were representing something, and just they were just so significant in most of the songs, and the way that they changed, and the way that, you know, became more prominent, or they were stripped back and taken away at certain moments. It maybe like as if it was like the character's mindset or something was the rhythm of her heart or the rhythm of her mindset. I don't know. I'm probably like way off base here, but that's how I feel. It's like the drums were their own character. Her vocals are unlike anybody else right now. Unlike anybody else out there. It's crazy how she can go from this sultry feeling and emotion, but she's able to take that sultry range and bring it up to where it's this little girlish, innocent harlot type sound. It creates this juxtaposition within the music and within the song itself. And the way she's able to do that is almost like she's playing a character, you know, who's coming off as this innocent girl who's just, oh, I'm out here, I'm just living my life, having new fun. But deep down inside or in her mind, she has her own agenda of what she wants to do. I'm so glad. I'm so glad that it was such a good album, because it just set the tone for the rest of this deep dive, and I'm just looking forward to doing the next album. Once again, guys, for these deep dives, I'm going to drop album reactions every Monday. I don't know how many albums she has. I think like 4 or 5 out right now. So for the next 4 or 5 Mondays, expect a Lana Del Rey album to drop. Make sure you guys subscribe, hit that little bell button so you get notifications of when I do drop those videos or when any other videos drop. That's it for now, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. If there's any Lana Del Rey songs that aren't on her albums that you would like me to react to, throw them down in the comments. Let me know what your favorite song is in the comments as well. Mine, I would have to say, is definitely Dark Paradise, for sure. Hands down, is the best song on the album. Hop on over to Instagram, give me a follow. I'm gonna follow back. And once again, I appreciate you guys watching. It really means a lot. You guys already know, stay safe, stay busy, and I will catch you guys next time.
I didn't see that coming.